to the Mensch. Today we're doing a 1 year update on the Iron Rangers. It's been a year since I posted that video review of the initial impressions that I had from the Iron Rangers. And in honor of Ranger Month, which is January, I'm gonna do an update, a 1 year update on these Iron Rangers. So I think we should jump right into it. I wanted to start first with the cosmetics of the boot, the leather quality. So let's get a little bit closer here. And just show the leather, which is so thick. It's the amber harness. It was very, very tough to just loosen up this leather. It's doing great. You can see that it has some scuffs all over the front there. It's not too bad, but it's got definitely has some scuffs. There's a big scratch in this one. It's doing very, very well. And to me, I want the scuffs. I want there to be some different patches of color, depending on the toe or on the sides. I really like that. So you can see that they're developing a nice character to the actual leather. So I used just a little bit of Smith's Leather Balm on the super dry area. So that would be like around the ankles here and on the toe where it would get very, very dry. I would use a little bit of Smith's Leather Balm. It's just a very light kind of conditioner. And I didn't want to discolor that brown boot. And I saw someone else on YouTube, if you guys have seen Stridewise, he really mink oiled up his Iron Rangers and they were like black now. So I didn't want that. I really like just letting them age naturally. If they get a little bit too dry, you can do a little bit, but nothing too major. The creasing, I think the creasing is another place to look at as far as how they age. And you can see that it's different. Like this one, if you look on the toe there, this one is doing very well. You can see that there's no loose grain. It's just like, when, especially when my foot's in there, they still look almost brand new. There's very minimal creasing. And this one though, you can see it's just a different piece of leather and it's a little bit looser the grain, which is a little bit less attractive. But as far as the quality goes and the performance of the leather, they're both very, very nice. Of course, these are factory first. So I'd note that if you have factory seconds, they might be a little bit looser, the grain, and it might not be as high of a quality of a cut of the leather, but again, they're gonna perform just as well. So these boots touch me my soul. So let's talk about the soles of the boot, okay? So these are actually the Red Wing proprietary cork nitrile soles. They do not make these anymore. Fun fact, they only make them with the Vibram soles now, with the mini lugs. So these have been aging. I just dropped the boot. Let me just get that. Hello. And they've been aging pretty well. So you can see that the stitching has worn away towards the front. You can see it's still there in the middle. And the heels, let me see the heels there. They've barely worn away. I mean, really nothing bad. I've seen people complain about them. I'm telling you, I wear these a lot. And they've been holding up really well. They're very, very dense in the sole. So they've been doing great. I should easily get another, I would say, 3 to 5 years out of them before they need a resole. So very, very happy with the way the soles have been aging. All right, so let's talk about the break-in. That's what everyone complains about with the Iron Rangers. Let's talk about actually breaking in that footbed, that footboard, the insole, whatever you want to call it, how that goes. So again, I like the hard leather footbed, so I never felt uncomfortable, but I can definitely tell you that the last time I made this video last year, it definitely was not nearly as broken in as it is now. And it just takes a lot of time. Around the sixth month of wear, that's really where I start to feel around the side edges of the leather and also the insole. I'm trying to get you a good job. You can see how dark it is. It really darkened the heel cup in the back there, and especially on this one also, and especially towards the toes. So I got the toes and really the heel cup. That's really, for me, where the biggest imprints are. And I still think it's a never-ending process. The arch is still, that's gonna take a lot more time if you think about it. The most of your weight is gonna be, you know, when you step, is going to be on the toes and on the heel. So to me, the middle, that arch, is going to take just, you know, a lifetime of breaking in until it actually breaks in fully. So again, for me, it wasn't too uncomfortable ever at any point. But for some of you, I'll just say around the 6 month mark, you should really already be seeing a lot more comfort in the insole. Another thing I wanted to note is about the stinkiness, because I do have smelly feet. They do sweat a lot. So as I mentioned in the first video, my feet do sweat a lot, but in these leather boots, which are unlined, so it's just the leather and then, of course, a leather footboard, like I mentioned, they actually don't sweat as much because I think the leather absorbs that moisture well. And also, I think the leather is porous and allows it to breathe. Whatever reason it is, I just find that I don't sweat nearly as much in these as I do in athletic sneakers. But they do still smell a little bit, but I specifically wanted to point out that they don't smell to me as much as athletic shoes, which I just think is very interesting. Yeah, it's really not bad at all. It doesn't stink up my room or anything like that. There is a little bit of a smell, but really not too bad. And lastly, I wanted to mention, in terms of break-in, the back here, something that I've come to really appreciate about these is this back support there. It's actually one piece of leather for that heel cup, and I just love it. The other boots do not have this, And it's just got this very nice supportive system. And I think it functions in two ways. One is that it actually provides support for your ankle and for your heel and your Achilles, but also it prevents the boot from collapsing on itself. And I'll show you maybe at some point with my mock toes when I do a video on that. It actually, everything's collapsing on that heel and it creates this unattractive kind of split right above the cap of the heel there. So I just really appreciate that about the Iron Rangers. I really do like this support system they have there. Okay, so in conclusion, of course I love the Iron Rangers. Iconic shoe, but I just want to speak to the haters right now. I'm talking to you haters, okay? First of all, people are complaining and moaning about how these are a hipster boot and they're not real rugged boots and that people are just wearing these as a fashion statement in Williamsburg. And I just wanted to say, if you don't get that these are really mostly for fashion, much more over function, you're totally missing the point. These are a heritage boot, okay? It's an homage to the past. It's an homage. It's not supposed to be something that people are working in. It's really supposed to be just something that's supposed to remind people of the good old days, and it's supposed to be something that people can wear and have pride for America and the history of America and the history of the brand. So I think the joke's on all those haters who are complaining about hipsters like me wearing these Iron Rangers. So I think, again, people should be able to enjoy the Rangers, take pride in them. They're still very, very functional, and it's still very, very comfortable and long-lasting boot. And I just want to say, everyone should own a pair, every guy, even if you're just a hipster and only wear them once every couple weeks. I still think that's something that people should own and take pride in and enjoy wearing. So thank you so much for watching, guys. Hopefully, at this point next year, I'll do a two-year update with the same Yankee hat that's smelly and stinky and gross, but hopefully you guys will stick with me. Please, I want to start talking more to the YouTube crowd, so guys, please show me support. I want to see some comments, and of course, you can follow me on Instagram, too. Have a good one, guys. It's been real.